In this video, we will look at how to do manual partitioning when installing Linux Mint, Linux Ubuntu, or any other distribution that uses Ubuntu Installer. The installer that you see in the background, this is called Ubuntu Installer. You know, when you install a distro, it comes with an installer. There are various installers. There's the Calamaris installer, there's the Ubuntu installer. Most Arch-based distros, they use Calamaris installers, and most Ubuntu-based distros, they use the Ubuntu installer. The picture that you are currently seeing on the screen, this is the Calamaris installer. However, because we are installing Linux Mint in this tutorial, we'll not be using the Calamaris installer. Instead, we'll be using the Ubuntu installer. Select the something else option. It'll take a little bit of while to load all the partitions. Give it a few seconds. Now the list has been populated. These are all the pre-existing partitions that you see on the screen. These partitions are all the pre-existing partitions on your system. Let's create a new partition. Select free space. Then click on the plus button you see on the screen to create a new partition. By the way, you can also click the minus button. You know, you have to, if you want to delete a partition, select the partition and then click the minus button to get rid of the partition. But for now, let's get back into the process of creating a new partition. You can adjust the size of the partition here. Now select the mount point. Mount point is basically where an external partition, storage device, or you know, file system can become accessible. To put simply, mount point is basically where the new file system or partition gets attached. By selecting root, we are ensuring that the new file system, you know, the new partition, it gets attached to the root of the Linux file hierarchy, you know, the Linux file structure. If it was, let's say, if you create a separate partition for your home directory and select the mount point as home, then that separate partition would get attached to the home folder. If you want, you can select another file system as well. I'm using the ext4 file system, but you can also go with the butterfs, or how some people pronounce btrfs file system, or any other file system. File system is basically how the files are stored and accessed on your, you know, partition, your any storage device, be it your SSD, your hard disk drive, you know. File system, you can think of it as a set of rules how files are accessed from your hard drive, or you know, how they are retrieved, how they are stored, how they are manipulated. Basically, think of the file system as a set of rules on how your computer manipulates the files. Now let's create a swap partition. Swap partition aids the RAM, you know, the random access memory. Think of it as your random access memory sidekick. You know, Robin is to Batman, you know, Batman cartoon show, Batman, you know, he has a sidekick called Robin. Think of the swap partition as your RAM's Robin, or your RAM's sidekick. Whenever, you know, RAM is full or almost full, it swaps the contents from the RAM onto the swap partition, and when the RAM is liberated, you know, it has more free space, it sort of retakes the content of the swap and puts it back into the RAM, back and forth. you know, when it's run with when it runs out of space, or when it has almost run out of space, it, you know, swaps some of the content onto, you know, puts some of the content onto the swap partition, and when, you know, it feels that it has more space available now, it, you know, reloads said data back into the RAM. The size of your swap partition should be greater than your RAM, you know. I use it as a rule of thumb. It's not necessary, but you know, I have 4 gigs of RAM, so I make sure that it's at least 5 GB, you know. I make sure that at least the size of my swap partition is 5 gigabytes. But in this, you know, in this example, I'm actually going with more than 5 gigabytes, you know, but the difference is marginal. Also notice this EFI partition. You know, the EFI partition is the single most important partition on your system. Basically, EFI contains the bootloader. Bootloader is something that picks up your operating system and loads it into the RAM. You know, picks up your operating system from your hard disk drive or SSD and unloads it into the RAM. EFI, you don't have to spare way too much, you know, memory for the EFI. Only 500 megabytes is enough. In my case, 629. But 500 or little over 500, like in my case, 629 MB is enough. In my case, like I said before, the EFI partition is already there. But for you, if it's not there, you can create the EFI's file system partition. Now look where it says device for bootloader installation. This option is only relevant if you have more than 2 storage medium. Let's say you have 2 hard disk drives, or you have 1 hard disk drive and 1 SSD. Most people, they have a single hard disk drive. Some people do have. I have seen laptops that, you know, that advertise two storage mediums, a hard disk drive as well as the SSD. This is important because, you know, this is where the EFI partition is located. So the system, it has to know in, let's say if there are 2 hard disk drive, which is the one that contains the EFI partition. Okay, so all seems good. Click on install now. It will ask you if you want to write the changes to the disk. Basically, it lists all the changes that are about to happen. Click on continue. And the remainder of the installation process is the usual, you know, like how it's supposed to be. If you like the video, then please consider subscribing my channel. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.